Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3, testing.
Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Testing, 1, 2, 3. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Testing. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Dusty Windham. Thanks for joining us here today for NMJC basketball as the Thunderbirds will be taking on Temple College and the Leopards. The Leopards coming in after a loss yesterday to South Plains College, dropping their record to 7-4 on the season. There's my guy. It's Luke Fay.
How are you doing, Dusty?
I'm doing good, man. Not only is it a Luke Fay sighting, it is a Luke Fay hearing. You see that? Everybody's hearing it.
Very, very rare these days.
It is. Sports Information Director here at New Mexico Junior College, and the guy that makes all these games work out for you at home and for everybody on the other side as well, man. Yesterday a bit nerve-wracking for you. A little calmer today, huh?
Yeah. Won't have to do the PA intros, which is good. We got a tie frame back in the house, so it takes a little bit off me, and then We had a real high-scoring game on the women's side yesterday. We went back through the record books to try to dive in. We don't have an overall record on most points in a game for the women's side, but since 2012, that's the most points that the Thunderbirds have scored.
You know what? I was wondering the same thing yesterday. And then, of course, on the three-point record that we talked about, the 1-3 shy was Holmes on the three-pointer. 7 made threes yesterday.
Yeah, and then 17 overall, if correct me if I'm wrong.
No, you're right.
That's got to be pretty much up there on the record books as well. So,
not too many teams hit that many per game, I'll promise.
Yeah, and I don't think that we do either.
So no, we don't.
It was falling last yesterday afternoon. And then on the men's side, you know, a good solid win. What was it, 33 points?
33-point victory yesterday. And against a scrappy team, really, the Costat team from University of Arkansas, Costat. The Colts were pretty scrappy, had a couple of really quick guards get some shots off, but they played well, Thunderbirds here in Hobbs, and they're ready to go again today. This is going to be a different test, though, with Temple here, a 7-4 team, hung to within 16 yesterday of the number one team in the country.
I mean, I would say this is probably our second or third most difficult game that we played so far this season. You know, earlier you go and beat Collin, lose to Panola, your only loss on the road. After a long trip, so
yeah, and third game too. During that trip.
So. Yeah, so I think that right now it'll be a nice test, and I mean, shoot, it's got to not feel too great going up against the number one team, and then you got to play the Thunderbirds
You know, Thunderbirds ranked again as well in the top 25. 21 is what, or 22 is what it was. Okay, 22 yesterday is what I saw. Then I for some reason I was thinking 21, but then again, you know how I think. So, but it's been a while since T-Birds have been ranked on the men's side, and Coach Luke McKay doing a heck of a job with this team.
Yeah, I mean, I think we're really excited. We got a player that's going to be coming back after this game. I believe it's going to be Trey Harris. So we haven't seen him at all this year. So he'll be able to play next game, and I know that the T-Birds really would love to have a nice little lift off the bench, maybe even into the starting role. So. Speaking of off the bench, how about Deuce Benjamin so far this year?
He's had a great season. Really provides a spark, brings the energy up every time he's in, and defensively really creates havoc. I'll tell you another thing, though. Chaden Stone yesterday started that game off for the T-Birds on fire, really got them going offensively. in the early going, and it was nice to see him really get his shot going that early in the ballgame.
I mean, I know overall the Thunderbirds didn't really shoot that great from three, and, you know, obviously Chayden did go, I believe, 4 for 5, so yeah. He himself had a great game, but doesn't it feel pretty good to make some threes? I know last year they weren't falling for us, so, you know, this year it seems like we've got a little bit better of a shooting team, and, you know, that makes it easier to score points and win games.
Really does, and the transition offense has been really good for them this season, coming off the steals and the tip passes. The guard play is unreal for this team, and they don't lose anything going to the bench, really,
no,
from the guard position, and that's got to be a nice problem to have for Coach.
I would assume that it's a calculated move by Coach McKay to keep Deuce on the bench just because of the energy that he brings off. You need that type of guy that can go and help you at the 14-minute mark in the first half, and then, I mean, he's going to be playing at the end of the game. It doesn't matter. You put your best players in at the end of the game. He'll be playing. Chayden will be playing. Leo Torber will be playing.
Man.
You got Antoine Massey, Bear Cherry. I mean, that's a scary lineup come the last 5 minutes of the second half.
You know, I got to talk to Bear a little bit before the game yesterday. He's shooting threes down in this corner pregame. I said, hey, man, that's not your shot, big guy. And he looks at me and says, it can be. He said, by the way, my mom wants to meet you, so I want to say hi to Bear's mom again. Hello. And hope to meet you someday,
I don't think,
man.
I've ever seen Bear take a jumper besides at the free throw line.
Yeah. You know, I don't either. But
I mean, when you're that big and down low, everything seems to be a mismatch.
You know, so. You know one thing you can't coach? 6'11".
No, you cannot. You cannot at all.
But I tell you, it's been a good early season for the T-Birds, both on the men's and women's side, as Luke Fay will head over for the spotlight during the introductions here at Castor Activity Center. We do want to thank you again. And we're going to continue on with the broadcast. We'll have a national anthem, but the Temple College Leopards here, they'll be in the black and, well, white and gold, I guess, today. They're a white and black and gold squad. And very reminiscent of the high school team here, the Hobbs Eagles. And your T-Birds will be dressed in red and black. T-Birds come in at 10-1, ranked 22nd in the country. And a tough task here today, as Temple played South Plains very well. South Plains, of course, in the WJCAC along with the Thunderbirds. And tell you what, ranked number one in the country, best conference in the United States here is the WJCAC for college basketball. And we're going to pause for the national anthem. There you have it, the national anthem, folks. Now starting lineups for both sides. For the Leopards, they will be starting first. Number two, a point guard, a 6'1 freshman from Finland, Aino Montin. Number four, from Shirts, Texas, the 6'3 sophomore guard, Theo Grant, also leading the team in scoring at just about 19 points a contest. Number 22, that'll be Andrew Iyama out of Dallas, Texas, a 6'7 sophomore forward, almost a 10 a game at 9.4. Number 24 out of San Antonio, Texas, the 6'7 freshman guard, Caleb Gaston, averaging 16, second on the Leopards squad in scoring. And your post player will be number 35. It looks like Jacob Tate. Tate is a 6'5 sophomore out of England. And for your Thunderbirds, pretty solid, consistent starting lineup, starting with the young man out of Las Vegas, Nevada. 6'5", sophomore guard, Xavier Johnson. Chaden Stone, who we talked about just a few moments ago here on the broadcast, a 6'3", sophomore guard out of Macon, Georgia. Number four, Leo Torber, the guy with some real length at that guard position. A 6'4", sophomore from Minneapolis, Minnesota. Number four, Leo Torber. Number 12, one of the returners from last season, along with the final gentleman we'll talk about here, from Olathe, Kansas, the 6'8", sophomore forward, Antoine Massey, wearing number 12. And, of course, my guy Bear, Jeremiah Bear Cherry, the 6'11", San Diego, California resident, a sophomore at 6'11", and he's had a really solid season and better playing shape than he was a season ago, has really battled inside and has had to it with his size, doesn't get all the calls that you think a post player would a lot of times, but Bear has really fought hard inside all season long. It's the strength, but it's his undying enthusiasm, it is his smile, it is his personality that really helps out with this team, along with undeniable skill in the post for the T-Birds. So it will be the Leopards. It will be the T-Birds. 40 minutes of basketball right here at Castor Activity Center today. And the T-Birds looking to finish, well, undefeated at home. Yet to lose on the Castor Activity Center floor this year. It's called Ron Black Court. There's a reason for that. If you don't know who Ron Black is, a legendary coach here and Hall of Famer at New Mexico Junior College. Always love to have him in the crowd. I haven't looked down to see if he's there today, but always good to have Coach Black around. So to tip it up, it will be Antoine Massey. He will win the tip against number 22, Iyama, and here we go. Underway at Castor Activity Center. Again, I'm Dusty Wendell. Thanks for being with us today on this Sunday tip-off. Torber now with the basketball for the T-Birds. We'll get the ball inside. There's Cherry just that quick, and they'll call a travel on him early on off the fake, and it will be Leopard basketball. A turnover early for the T-Birds, something they didn't have much of a problem with yesterday, as they were able to, I think they only committed six in the first half period in yesterday's ball game. First shot by the Leopards is put up by number 24, Gaston. It's a three, he'll miss it. And T-Birds come back up the floor with the ball. Chaden Stone, who got started very well yesterday, gets the ball to Cherry. Cherry's going to put it back over to Xavier Johnson. Back out to Stone. They'll look inside for Cherry. He's got his man posted and a bit of a size advantage there. And Stone's going to turn around near the free throw line after picking up his dribble. Hangs in the air. It's off front iron, and back up the floor comes Monton. It's number four, Theo Grant with the basketball. Gets it low, and along the baseline goes the player. Loses the basketball. Chaden Stone will rip it away from Iyama, and back up the floor come the T-Birds. Leo Torber will get it down low to Bear. Bear mishandles it as he's bumped in the back. And back up the floor come the Leopards. Monton with it now. He'll go right against Stone now. Coming out was Cherry for the help. They got a hand on the pass, and somehow the Leopards come away with the basketball. And Caleb Gaston will score the first bucket of the game. It is 2-0 Temple over your T-Birds with 18:20 to go in the first half. Wide open for a baseline jumper. Misses it short. It's off iron. Massey grabs his own rebound, and it's out of bounds off of him and back to Temple College. Bit of a slow start for the T-Birds as opposed to yesterday's quick start. And we'll see if the defense can get another stop here. 18:07 remaining now in this first half, and the T-Birds up, or down 2-0, excuse me. Thinking about the three was Theo Grant. He'll have to kick it out, though. And that is going to be number 35, Jacob Tate, for the three. It's 5-0 now. T-Birds down. We'll see if they can score on this offensive possession, as they've turned it over on their first couple. It's going to be Johnson for three. This one halfway down, rattles out, and back up the floor come the Temple College Leopards. On the far side now, looking for the baseline. And having it knocked away from him is number 24, Caleb Gaston. Torber with the defense for the Thunderbirds that time. Monten will look to inbound with 19 on the shot clock here as the Leopards will try to get it in. Stone with the steal on the interception from the inbound pass. Back up the floor comes Stone. He's going to take it right at the bucket, and he's able to lift up and get that thing off the glass and in. 5-2, T-Birds trail it now. Stone with the first bucket for the T-Birds. Now T-Birds will look for another defensive stop. Wide open again up top are the Leopards for a three. They'll miss this one. Massey comes away with a rebound for New Mexico. Stone now gets the screen from Cherry up top. Just misses on the tray. And back up the floor come Temple College. Monten will get it ahead to Grant, the leading scorer on this Temple College team. Now they'll look to get it down low. They will back up top. And back over to Grant in the corner. Bear has to come all the way out on the rotation. Switches off, and he'll get called for the foul. It'll be his first and the T-Birds' first. 16:35 still remaining here in this first half, and the T-Birds down three. It's 5-2. Monten will inbound. Long three up off back iron. No good, and coming away with it is going to be Torber now as it goes off the hands of Johnson. Torber goes up with the left hand off the glass. 5-4 now. T-Birds trail by one. Temple really quickly back up the floor. And Monten fakes the three, puts it on the floor. Dribbles back out, gives it off to Grant. Grant is guarded here by Torber. Torber forces him to go down low to Iyama. Iyama can't get around Cherry. Back out to Monten for three. No. And now a offensive rebound, a pass back under, goes off the hands of Chayden Stone, out of bounds, and the T-Birds will have to defend underneath the bucket. 20 on the shot clock. There is 15:59 remaining here in this first half, and a couple of substitutions now here for the Leopards. Monten gets it in. It's going to be Grant for three. Oh, that is not Grant. Excuse me. Looks like that was, again, Tate. His second tray of the game. He's got 6 of the 8 points for Temple College here, and they lead it 8-4. Back down under. They get it to Cherry. Cherry with the turnaround, the hook from the baseline. No. And another rebound. Good job boxing out so far by Temple in this one. Cherry with a block on the attempted dunk this time from Tate, and the T-Birds will come back up the floor with the basketball. Three put up by Johnson. No. And Antoine Massey is going to get called for going over the back of number 5, and that is Jarrell Peoples. Peoples out of Austin, Texas. 6'5", sophomore. Looks like Sincere Shaw checking in, number 11, out of St. Louis, Missouri. He's a 6'7 freshman himself. And number 12, Desmond Green out of New Orleans, Louisiana, a 6'9", sophomore post. 8-4 your score here. Temple in the lead over your T-Birds at the moment. 15:23 to go here in this first half. This is going to be number 30, Henry Sanchez Perez out of Copperas Cove, Texas, in the game for Temple. And again, they're just getting looks from three-point range all day so far are the Temple College side. Another three made there, and that'll make the score 11-4 here. T-Birds are down 7 at home. Deuce Benjamin in the game for the T-Birds gets trapped in the corner, finally gets the pass across to Leo Torber, underneath to Massey. Massey with the turnaround. The pump fake goes back up. Can't get it to fall. Luca Beret on the putback. Tips it home for the T-Birds, and it's a five-point game. Wide open again all the way down the floor. This time it's Peoples for a bucket. And it's 13-6. T-Birds still trailing. Beret gets it all the way down to Massey, who'll go off the glass and in. And Twan has his first bucket of the game. 13-8 your score. T-Birds still down by 5, looking for a stop here. This time defense is able to get back in time. This is a team that matches up well quickness-wise with the T-Birds. I'll tell you that from the early going. T-Birds will first force a turnover there on defense, And they'll get it back here as we go to our first media timeout. I had to look up. I heard a whistle and didn't even realize it was time for that timeout. So, 14-16 remaining here in this first half. And your T-Birds trail it by 5 to Temple College. Number 22 in trouble early. We'll be back in just a few moments. All right, we are back again at Castor Activity Center. Coming out of our first media TO of the day, T-Birds trailing early here at home to Temple College and the Leopards. It's 13-8, a five-point game, and so far it's been timely three-point shooting for this Temple squad. Three of them made so far in the game for 9 points, two of them from Jacob Tate, one from Sincere Shaw, and of course, Jarrell Peoples and Caleb Gaston, each with a two-point field goal for the Leopards. On the other side, T-Birds have had points from Massey, Torber, Bray, and Stone, but those are all four buckets T-Birds have had. And they've struggled a bit to get back on defense. We'll talk to Coach Jordan Burton, assistant coach, at halftime to see what adjustments they may or may not make. Bray will get it back from Torber as he was bumped up. Benjamin. Now, we'll work with the basketball. We talked about him pregame with Luke Fay. And Deuce will try to go baseline. He'll get around everybody. And with a reverse layup, put it up off the glass and in. Deuce for two. 13-10 your score. Now we're inside of 14 minutes to play here in the first half. And good defense being played by Torber. Massey gets a hand on the entry pass. It will go off of Antoine and out of bounds and stick with Temple College. Torber will take a seat now as Elijah Bailey will enter the game for the Thunderbirds. 5'11 sophomore guard out of Brooklyn, New York. The inbound to Desmond Green all the way back up top. Now to Shaw. Shaw gives it off for Cameron Roper in the game out of San Antonio as well. And underneath, could not get the shot to fall for Peoples. He hits the bottom of the rim, and the T-Birds come back up to four. It is knocked away, and beyond the baseline, T-Birds will inbound from underneath their bucket. It'll be Bailey to inbound. They'll get it to Massey. Massey with a leap gets to that one, and now puts it up and in. Good defense with no foul that time for the Leopards, and T-Birds will press it up a little bit. Now they'll back off without the trap there and into the half court. So right now it's Roper with the basketball. He tries to go around Benjamin. Benjamin's going to get called for a bump here, I believe. That is the call. It'll be his first. Teague's third. No fouls the other way in the first almost 7 minutes of play. Cherry checks back in for New Mexico. It'll give Antoine Massey a breather. Massey's got four for New Mexico here in the game. And they trail it by one. 13-12 with 13:02 to go in the first half. The inbound comes in. That is Perez. Now all the way out for another three. They seem to get really good open looks. Cherry with a long rebound while being held. No call. But he's able to come away with the basketball. Elijah Bailey from the top. He'll drain the tray, and the T-Birds have a lead. First of the day for the T-Birds. 15-13, your score here at Castor Activity Center. Ball passed, and gentleman being guarded here, trying to work his way in, actually traveled, but is going to get away with that one, is Sincere Shaw. Shaw's got five now in the ball game with that bucket, and we're tied at 15 here. There's a trip right there, no call. And the T-Birds will finally come away with it again after a foul is called here against number 5 Peoples. That'll be the first team foul against Temple. And, of course, the first against Peoples. So Iyama will check back in the game for Temple. T-Birds have Bray, Benjamin, Cherry, Ayul, and Bailey in the game. Ayul in for the first time, and a three put up by Benjamin, and the T-Birds now up by three. 18-15, 12 minutes to go in the first half. Deuce with 5 points for New Mexico. And that is number, I believe, 24, Caleb Gaston with the basketball. It is. The gold numbers on the white jersey is kind of hard to see a little bit, but we'll get there. Gaston will get the bucket as Bailey elects not to foul there. Gaston now with four. 18-17, T-Birds. Deuce into the corner to Bray, underneath to Cherry. The turnaround hook, no good. Just a little bit off his spot that time. On, it goes off front iron, and the ball goes all the way back down to Perez. Perez has one blocked about a mile from Cherry. Cherry with a huge rejection that time. The ball will remain down here with Temple. Xavier Johnson checks back in for the Thunderbirds, as does Chayden Stone. It is Bray getting a breather. A good inbound play there for Temple as the pass comes in from Roper. And they'll get the ball to Gaston. Gaston now with six, averages 16 a game for this Temple College team. They regain the lead at 19-18 with 11:06 to play in this first half. T-Birds now with the basketball. Stone will float and put it up and in. Chayden Stone with his second bucket. 4 points for him now, and T-Birds regain it at 20-19. Really competitive first half so far, and a lot of fun to watch here at Castor Activity Center. If you're not here and have a chance, come on out and watch some of this basketball. It is high quality action. Oh, looked like Stone had saved that and didn't need to. It was off a white shirt. T-Birds would have had possession. Stone steps on the line while trying to save it, and the ball will go back over to Temple. 10:41 remaining here in the first half. T-Birds up 20-19. Pass comes in quickly to Iyama. Iyama gets it over to Grant. Grant now trying to work against Benjamin. Can't get around him. Benjamin's going to get called for another foul as he hip checks him. And that's two on Deuce. Four team fouls now for the T-Birds. Ayule will get ready to check back into the game here. The buzzer sounds and he will enter the game for Deuce. 10:31 remaining here in this first half. 20-19. T-Birds have trailed by as many as seven. Came back, took a three-point lead, and now lead it by one. Temple to inbound here, trying to get it to Grant. That's a five-second call. Should have been. Seemed like 5 seconds anyways. I wasn't counting it off myself. They will inbound it. They'll get it over to Roper. Roper into the corner. I believe that is number 11, Shaw. He'll hit another tray, and the T-Birds find themselves down two. It's 22-20 Temple. There's the oop. Nice pass there from Ayule down to Bear Cherry. We're tied. Cherry's first bucket of the game, and a miss on the other end by Temple. Back up the floor come the T-Birds. Ayule down there. He's going to get fouled. Took a while for that whistle to come out, a little bit late, and Ayule will head to the free throw line for the T-Birds. 9:56 remaining in the first half. We're going to have a second media timeout. I love those things, you know. Allows me to catch my breath and talk to you guys a little bit fresher when we come back. T-Birds and Temple tied at 22, 9:56 to go in the first half. We'll be back. We are back once again here at Castor Activity Center. Sunday afternoon basketball, nothing better right here at New Mexico Junior College. Tied at 22 right now with Temple College as both teams up and down the floor shooting the ball pretty well. T-Birds will be at the free throw line in the form of Ayule Ayule when we resume the action momentarily. But the T-Birds found themselves down by as many as seven early in this contest. Three-point shooting has been big for the Leopards in this one, as I believe they've drained five already, which is what I have, yes. And look like they'll continue to do so. I mean, they're really hitting the deep shots here early on that found some really good open looks. Again, we'll talk with Jordan Burton at the half about that, the men's assistant basketball coach here at New Mexico Junior College. Yule at the line sinks his first to give the T-Birds a one-point lead. 23-22 as he gets a second look here. It's off front iron, does not fall, and the rebound is grabbed here by Gaston. Here comes Temple back up the floor. And they'll go low and even lower now. Right into the player Gaston underneath the bucket. And he'll lay it up and in. 24-23, Gaston's got eight for the Leopards. And Temple has a one-point lead. There's Stone again, and he's going to go up for the shot. And he'll be fouled as he's landing there. This one will go against number 22, and that is Iyama. That's two on him, 13 foul now for the Leopards, and two shots coming here for Chaden Stone. Stone, again, was hot early yesterday from the floor and now has five in this one as he'll sink his first. A couple of field goals have fallen for him. So Monton is back in, as is, it looks like, Desmond Green for Temple College. Second shot is up and in for Stone as well. T-Birds regain the lead at 25-24. Back and forth we go here as both teams able to score the basketball pretty much at will. Grant trying to get loose from Leo Torber back in the game for the Thunderbirds, and there's a drive there by Gaston. He's blocked by Cherry. T-Birds will come away with the basketball. It's Torber back up the floor, gets it to Stone. He'll catch the pass, go down low to Cherry. Cherry's going to try to back his way in. He'll spin, pivot. Has it knocked away from him? He picks it back up. No. Johnson knocked it back out. Grant comes away with the rebound, though, for Temple. Monton will look. He'll go down low, working against Cherry. They'll come back up top, thinking better of that. Grant looking for space. Torber giving absolutely none. Averages 19 a game. Has yet to score in the game here. Monton gets it back. From, is that Gaston? Yes, it was. Now into the lane. That's going to be a charge here. An offensive foul against number 35, Jacob Tate. That'll be, I believe, his first and the team's fourth. Pardon me. T-Birds will get the ball back here after the foul. And with 8.5 to go, they're wide open by himself down here is Antoine Massey. That's going to prompt Temple to take the TO here. T-Birds back up by three. It is 27-24 after the lapse in defensive, well, awareness there for Temple College. We're going to give you some NFL scores here. As it is Sunday, I get to rarely do this for the folks at home, so I will get into my scores here. And right now, in the fourth quarter, about 12 minutes to go in the game, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers up over the Atlanta Falcons 19-10. Cincinnati with a 17-point lead in the fourth quarter, about 11 minutes to go in that ball game over the Indianapolis Colts. It's 31-14. Browns up over the Jaguars 21-7 in the third quarter. The New York Jets over the Houston Texans 21-6 now with 9 minutes to go in that game. The Rams have the football and a two-point lead with 4 minutes to go in the third quarter over the Baltimore Ravens, 22-20. 19-13 Bears ahead of the Lions at the end of three. Panthers trailing the Saints 14-6 with 11 minutes to go in that ballgame, and that's a look at the scores so far in the NFL today. Woo, what a move and a left-handed dunk. One-handed coming from Gaston, who turns and lets Antoine Massey know about it. Massey fouls on the play as well to compound the problem for the T-Birds. That is his first. Yeah, that's Massey's first foul and fourth foul. So at the line will be Gaston. He got around Massey and took flight. Threw it down with the one hand, but he'll miss the free throw. T-Birds still with a one-point lead, 27-26, 8:09 as Cherry got the rebound. He'll get it back here. And now stepping back is Stone for three, way short. It's going to be a long rebound. Stone will run it down. T-Birds get it back, and they'll go inside to Cherry. Cherry gets tied up. And it will be Temple basketball here. Cherry having all kinds of trouble in the post as they're sagging in when he gets the ball down low. And right now, the hands were quick that time and able to tie him up. Ball over to Grant now for the Leopards. Clear across. Peoples goes to Gaston, and Gaston will hit the tray. He is having a ball game. 13 for Gaston in this one already in the first half. T-Birds now find themselves behind. 29-27 after the three. And they'll look to tie it up or take the lead on this possession. Ayul wide open. He'll take the three from the corner. No. Rebound grab. Looked up by Peoples this time. Monten with it. Goes to the far side. Getting a screen, and Monten gets it back. Goes for the three, not this time. Cherry with another board. Gives it off to Bailey. Bailey will try to speed up the floor and now slow it down a bit as he waits for some more teammates to get down. Bailey with the hesitation out to Beret. Beret for three. No. Cherry had the offensive board, and it goes off the back of a Temple player. Grant will go at the bucket and get his first field goal of the game. 2 points for Grant. And with 6:47 remaining in the first half, T-Birds are down by four here at home. Bailey with another chance at three, and the T-Birds just can't get that going. Cherry with the offensive rebound, goes up for the shot off glass, and good. Monten did everything he could defensively, but just not big enough for that stop that time. Long three, air ball, Bray gets it back. T-Birds will come back up the floor. Chance to tie or take the lead on this possession. 31-29, your score, 6:20 remaining now in this first half. Bailey with the short arm on the floater that time, off front iron. And up the floor comes Tate. Tate will work against Ayul. Ayul, good defense. Wide open out is Grant. He'll put up the tray. He'll miss this one. Bray with the rebound. Over to Chayden Stone. T-Birds will slow it down inside of 6 minutes here. 5:52 remaining in this first half. T-Birds trail it 31-29, but they have the ball. Stone's going to get towards the bucket and leaves off a good pass for a trailing Bear Cherry. And Cherry now has six in the game. We're tied at 31. Ayul guarding against Tate here. Now back over to Peoples. Peoples. Far side. There's the fake from... We're going to have another offensive foul. This one will go against Gaston. Gaston with a head fake. Got his man up in the air, and it comes in. And it'll be a fresh five, it looks like. Oh, no. Maybe not. Yeah, it's going to be a fresh five on the floor for this Temple College team. As they've got one, two, three, four. There's six guys on the floor right now as Monten will head out. He was the lone holdover from the big substitution. 31 apiece here as the T-Birds and Temple College are doing battle. Here comes a little more pressure. Torber with the ball. We'll get it back over to Bailey. Bailey pulls it back out, and the T-Birds will set up some offense. The screen coming from Beret. He'll pop out at the top, shoot the three. This one does not fall. Rebound off glass and then grabbed by Temple. Xavier Johnson on the defense here was working against Roper. Roper kicks it out. It will be from the corner for, is that number 11? It was Shaw. And somehow off of that one, Temple gets the ball back. Torber will pick up his first, but he makes sure the bucket does not fall that time with a good physical basketball play. That, by the way, is going to be the fifth team foul against the T-Birds as Torber picks up his first. 4:51 remains before the halftime break. And your T-Birds are tied with Temple at 31 apiece here at Castor Activity Center in the second of two games for each team on the weekend. Temple losing to South Plains yesterday. Your Thunderbirds beating University of Arkansas Custod by 33 yesterday. South Plains number one in the nation in JUCO. And not a bad loss, but 16-point loss for Temple. 31 all. We'll be back in a moment. All right, New Mexico Junior College fans, this is Dusty Windham back again here from Kester Activity Center. We're inside of 5 minutes playing the first half, tied at 31 with Temple. And Temple having a good day shooting from outside. T-Birds have done a little bit of everything, but haven't played their best ball. There have been a lot of open shots from outside on the perimeter for Temple, and something they'll certainly address at halftime in the locker room. As we come back to action here, it'll be a free throw here, or a pair of them, coming for Cameron Roper. The foul, by the way, was on Torber. It was his first, team's fifth, and the free throw is up and good for Roper. Roper with his first points there. 32-31, a one-point lead for Temple pending this free throw. Short on it, and Torber gets the rebound. T-Birds will come back up the floor looking to take the lead here. 4:45 remaining now. Torber will go right at the bucket, throw it down with one hand over a couple of Temple College Leopards. Man, I didn't think he was going to dunk it. I saw he had a lane to the bucket, but I didn't think he was going to be able to throw it down like that. Leo with a big shot. Now a three put up, short, and an offensive rebound here. Perez missed the shot. Holder got the rebound, and now we'll kick it out. And Sincere Shaw has his third tray made of the game. 11 points for him. There's Bear Cherry with the two-handed dunk. And I tell you what, the defense inside not looking great. Elijah Bailey gets the steal there, but steps on the baseline trying to save himself. He is up. Good thing he's not hurt as he went down on his chest there. But that was a big defensive play. Big dunk by Bear Cherry. 8 points now for Jeremiah Cherry. We're tied at 35, 4 minutes to go in this one in the first half anyways. And now Torber giving fits to Roper. Roper gets a pass off. And now a steal by Bailey. And what a move to get it underneath. Ayul couldn't handle the pass and can't save it. He's into the stands and rubs the kid's head there on the front row. He's going to be a fan favorite just for that. So T-Birds turn it over, and we're tied at 35. 3:40 remaining in the first half. Temple with the basketball. They'll go for Shaw. Now back over for Henry Sanchez Perez. Clear across the floor and into the corner for a three. This one is up, rattles out, luckily for the Thunderbirds. And Bailey, he'll stop and he'll take the three off the long pass, and Bailey will hit it, his second of the game. 6 points for Elijah Bailey, and the T-Birds are back up by three with 3:10 to go in the first half. 38-35, your score. Behind the back that time, nice little move from Perez, and the shot is up and will fall. 37-35 as Perez gets his first bucket of the game. Or 38-37, excuse me, I said 37-35 when I looked down at the roster here. Three from Luca Beret on the other side. T-Bird starting to warm up from outside, and that's a good sign. 41-37, T-Bird have a four-point lead. Bailey will pick up a foul here as trying to get to the bucket was Perez. First on Bailey, sixth team foul, I believe. That is the case. So Grant is back in the game this time for Shaw. Again, he's the leading scorer for Temple, and he's been held so far to just two. Oh, they will say it's 17 foul. And the free throw is up. And it will fall. 41-38 the score. Both free throws good for Sancho Perez here. He has four in the game, and it's 41-39. T-Bird still with a two-point lead. 2:43 remaining here in this first half. And they get the ball over to Stone. Stone off the legs of a Temple College player. Torber will receive a long pass here. He gets fouled from behind. They turn Torber. He turned him around. He's up in the air. They grab the jersey. They spun him. And they'll give the ball back over. Maybe I missed that, but Maybe they did too. We'll see. 41-39, 2:25 in this first half. Grant with the basketball trying to work against Chaden Stone. Grant stops, shoots, and scores as he lost Stone for just long enough to get the shot off. Grant now with four in the first half. And there is a pass to a gentleman in the front row from the T-Birds. Another turnover, and now Temple with a chance to regain the lead with 2:04 remaining here in the first half. Bailey back in the game, and it was Johnson that took a seat for the Thunderbirds. 2 minutes to play now in this first half, 41 all between Temple and your Thunderbirds. Cameron Roper with the basketball now for Temple, being guarded by Ayul. They'll go inside, and a travel called underneath this time on Desmond Green. Ball goes back over to the Thunderbirds, who have a chance to regain the lead themselves. Tied at 41, 1:49 remaining now. In this first half, to inbound it will be Stone. He's looking for Bailey or Torber. Bailey will get it. He'll go back to Stone. Stone takes the pass to Torber. Back to Bailey. Get it across the timeline. They do. Back to Stone. He just goes right into the lane. Has a floater off back iron. It does not fall. Gets it back. And puts it off glass. No good. Long rebound. Out to Bailey now for three. No. And a foul. And will go back the other way. This one is going to go against Ayul. That'll be the first on Ayul. And the eighth team foul. So heading to the line again will be Temple College, this time in the form of, looks like Gaston back in the game. Gaston has had a good first half, 13 points, leads all scorers in the contest so far. And so now let's see a discussion by the officials. And after a long discussion with everybody out on the floor, I guess. I have no clue what the holdup was there, but 41 apiece is your score. At the free throw line will be Jason Holder for Temple. He'll sink his first and be awarded a second. First point of the game now for Holder. Holder also from England, Sheffield College. And Holder will sink both. A couple of players from the UK over there on this Temple squad. T-Birds will inbound here, trailing by two, 43-41, a minute 25 to go in the first half. Bray for three, and he changes all that quickly. His second of the game. Luca has eight in this first half off the bench. Nice spark for the T-Birds as it's 44-43 NMJC. It's Torber giving fits over here to the ball handler, who will give the ball off to Cameron Roper. Roper working against Ayul, loses it, it's knocked away, and with five on the shot clock, will Temple get a shot off? The fake there, and they do not. That is a shot clock violation. Good defense by the Thunderbirds late in this first half. 48 seconds left, and the T-Birds with a one-point lead. 44-43, and great defense there from your Thunderbirds. Torber with the basketball. He'll work against Grant. He'll get it across midcourt. Kick it over to Ayul. He'll fake the three. He'll drive. And he'll get bumped trying to get up for the shot. It will be two. No, it will not be. They're going to call it on the floor here. 35 seconds to go. That's two on Gaston. Got to be careful here not to get him a third one if you're Temple before the halftime buzzer, because he's been your offense. 13 points of it so far. Leads all scorers in the game. Sixth team foul, Bray. And now a whistle here. What? I think it's away from the ball, and it'll be Leo Torber. And he is teed up. Two on Leo here. Now, and free throws and the basketball for Temple. Not what you want to see late in the first half here. I wasn't looking near Leo as he was on the near side. The ball was on the far side of the floor. And do not know exactly what happened there. Both free throws will fall for number 30, and that is Henry Sanchez-Perez. It's a six-point first half for Perez, and it's 45-44 with 33 seconds to go in the half. What are they going to do? How did T-Birds get the ball back? I'm completely confused now. Either way, 45-44. T-Birds with the basketball. They trail it by one. 25 seconds left. And there is going to be a foul here called against Roper. Right in front of his own bench, and they did not like the call. They felt like he had the ball and it was a clean steal, but it will send Elijah Bailey to the free throw line. With just under 24 ticks left in the first half, T-Birds trail it by one. Bailey misses the free throw. Paredo with a big offensive board here for the Thunderbirds, and the T-Birds control here. Probably will have the last shot of the half. They trail it by one. And I think that's what they're playing for. We're down to 9 seconds. 6 seconds. With the drive and a jumper from the free throw line is Chayden Stone. He'll sink it. And that will end your first half with the T-Birds up by one on the bucket from Chayden Stone. 8 points for Stone. And the T-Birds have a 46-45 lead over Temple at the half. We'll take a quick break. We'll be back with some stats and some thoughts on this first half with Jordan Burton, men's basketball assistant coach here at New Mexico Junior College. So stay tuned, folks. Heck of a game here at Castor today. Okay, folks, we are back here at Castor Activity Center. Again, I'm Dusty Windham. And at the half, your T-Birds clinging to a one-point lead, 46-45 over Temple College. Joining me now, Jordan Burton. And, Coach, man, you guys got off to a pretty slow start. Found yourselves down by about seven in the early going. Kind of got it rolling offensively. What got you going offensively?
Yeah, we started that game. We weren't really ready to play. I don't think we were very locked in on what was in front of us. And I think what got us going was just a little bit of energy. We started talking a little bit and started getting stops defensively, and that'll always inject you with some energy. And I think you saw that go, you know, probably midway through the first half. We started picking it up. And now the struggle is you let some people feel good. You know, number 11 for them, Sincere Shaw, shoots it really well. He has 3 threes in the first half. He feels good, right? Now you have to slow some of those guys. You let get off to quick starts. Caleb Gaston's the same way.
Yeah.
Now the challenge is really sitting down and guarding those guys.
Yeah. You're holding Grant to just 4 points so far in the game. He's their leading scorer at about 19 a game. So you guys have locked down there, but they've had way too many open looks, I'm sure, for your liking from the perimeter.
Yeah, the big thing is they're one of the fastest teams in the country. They press as much or more than we do. Right? They love living in transition, and we're not doing a great job of finding them in transition. So you're seeing them, you know, shoot it and then turn and run, or whenever we shoot it, they're immediately running and pushing it back at us. And we got to do a better job of identifying who we're guarding and finding them early so they're not getting that full head of steam and finding shooters.
Now, Bear's got 8 points in the first half. It looks like you'd like to get him going a little bit more here in the second. Twan had a couple of early fouls and you know, sat a little bit. But I'm sure we'll see him in there. Is the post something you want to really get the ball down into in this one?
Yeah, we feel like we can overwhelm them there. In the first half, those two guys were 7 for 12 combined, and, you know, they really did a good job of getting deep catches. Got to do a little bit better job of finishing down there, but we think we can exploit that. But it's a matter of being able to get the ball there. You know, and, you know, we turned the ball over 7 times, and I feel like some of those turnovers weren't really forced turnovers. Those were just our mistakes. So being able to take advantage of that, get deep post touches, and take advantage of our size advantage.
Well, Coach, thanks for coming up. Hopefully we'll get it together here in this second half and stay perfect at home.
Yes, sir. Appreciate you. Thank you so
Thank
much.
You. Jordan Burton, ladies and gentlemen, a men's basketball assistant coach here and one of the nicest guys on the planet, no doubt about it, one of my faves. Really good halftime interview as well. 46-45, T-Birds are leading by one at the half, and we'll start with the stats for Temple Colleges. 13 points led the way from Caleb Gaston. Jacob Tate was 6 for the starters and 4 more for Grant. That's it from the starting 5 there for this Temple College team. 11 more for Shaw off the bench. He had 3 trays, 3 of 6 shooting from 3-point range in that first half. 7-9 as a team from the free throw line, 6 of 18 from 3, and also 47% from the 4 in the game, 16 of 34. And on those 16 buckets, they've had 10 assists. 7 turnovers for each team here. Rounding out the scoring for Temple is going to be Henry Sanchez Perez with 6, 2 apiece for Peoples and Holder, and a point for Cameron Roper. 15 rebounds grabbed and 4 on the offensive glass for Temple in that first half. And really no advantage inside, but their outside shooting has been a bit of a difference, making 6 trays. Your T-Birds have made 5 out of 14 for 35% in that first half. Not bad. They'd like to tighten that up a little bit, but they're shooting 50% from the floor as a team, are the T-Birds, at 19 of 38 on the game. Only getting to the line 5 times, though. They're going to look to change that in the second half as they've given up 9 free throws. 3 out of 5 for the T-Birds, though, for 60%. Rebounding, T-Birds have the edge there, 21 to 15, 7 to 4 on the offensive glass as well. 7 turnovers each for the teams. As we said, T-Birds with 8 assists on 19 buckets, which means they're getting to the bucket sometimes by themselves, which is good. But coach does want to see them finish inside and get the ball into the post a little bit more. T-Birds were led in the first half by the 8 points of Luca Beret off the bench, 8 for Cherry, 8 for as well Chayden Stone in that first half. To go along with those 8 points for Stone, he had 3 rebounds, 2 steals, and an assist. Cherry had 5 boards and a couple of block shots in that first half. 6 more coming from Antoine Massey with a couple of boards, but he's only played 7 minutes in this one, and he's going to have to stay on the floor for coach. Picked up 2 early fouls. Hopefully he'll be able to stay on the floor a bit more in the second half. 4 points for Torber with 3 assists and 3 rebounds as well. A couple of steals for Stone, and a couple also for Elijah Bailey. So 4 steals coming from the guard position. That's all the steals the T-Birds had in the first half. For Luca Bray, he's got 4 rebounds to go along with those 8 points off the bench and an assist as well. 6 more from Bailey, as we said. 5 from Deuce Benjamin, who also picked up a couple of early fouls in this one. Only 5 minutes for Deuce in the game so far. 1 point coming from Ayul, but Ayul with a couple of rebounds and assist as well in that first half. Three assists from Torber leads the way for your T-Birds with the distribution of the basketball. We got about 4:15 remaining here before we get rolling again. I'm going to go wet my whistle here and check out the facilities before we get going again. But the T-Birds leading 46-45 at the half over Temple. And we'll be back for what promises to be a great second half. We are back again here at Castor Activity Center. T-Birds will have the ball to begin this second half. As you see, T-Birds in red, white jerseys for Temple College. T-Birds lead it 46-45. Leo Torber with the drive, kicks it out into the corner. Now back over to Jaden Stone. Stone to Massey. And Massey's going to get it back to Leo Torber. Torber will back it out. Now we'll go right, then left. Back to Cherry as they get the switch they wanted. Ball stripped from Bear. Tipple comes away with a turnover on the first possession here of the second half. And a chance to take the lead for them. Monin is back in the game. Is it? Isn't it? Nope. Yeah, Montin. Excuse me. I forgot the T on that one. Here we go. Back up to four. T-Birds will come away with a turnover of their own. It's Leo Torber looking for Cherry. Cherry backs his way in, and he is held. And the foul will be called against the Yama. That's his third. Yama has yet to score in the game and just picked up his third. And so it looks like he may be coming out. Off the inbound, Cherry gets it. It's going to be four on Iyama now. Off the pump fake, gets Iyama in the air. And, well, he was already probably heading to the bench. And for sure now, off, I've got him for four. Yeah, that is four. So Cherry will head to the line here. It was announced as his third. And Bear with 8 points in the first half. Goes off front iron on his first attempt here, a little flat. And coming in for Iyama is going to be Desmond Green. Green out of New Orleans, 6'9 sophomore. Cherry with a chance to give T-Birds a two-point lead with a free throw here. And he does sink it. 9 points now for Bear as back up to four come Temple College. Monton will get that pass just in front of Xavier Johnson over to Jacob Tate. Tate now working and tries to get back to Monton. He does. Monton almost lost it there. And Stone almost came away with a steal. Massey now was guarding, and they'll get it back to Monton. Monton over to Gaston. Gaston just couldn't handle it. It goes off his fingertips, out of bounds, and the T-Birds will get it back off the turnover. 18:42 to go in this second half, and if you're just now tuning in, you missed one heck of a first half. 46-45 was your score then. It's 47-45 now. We're a minute and 25 into this second half. T-Birds with the two-point lead and the basketball. T-Birds in red again and white shirts for this Temple team. Here's Bear Cherry with the offensive rebound and the putback. Second chance points are going to be big in this one. And Cherry now has 11. Monte right back up to four with the basketball for Temple. And Massey almost coming away with a steal against Gaston here. Gaston's looking for somewhere to go with the ball. Torber gets a finger on it. And Massey hits the floor. Massey hits the floor, gets the basketball, the loose ball. And it's going to be T-Bird ball. And a timeout called by Temple early on, a minute 55 into this second half. They've got two left in the ball game. And your T-Birds up by four. It's 49-45. And the Thunderbirds are going to have to continue to use good defense and good shooting here. As we talked with Jordan Burton at half, they're going to try to work the ball in a little bit more. They've gone to Bear a couple times already here in this second half. This will be the third T-Bird possession here of this second half when they come back up to fourth. And long time out there, 18:05 to go here in the ball game. And I'm sure not one that Temple wanted to spend at that particular time, but coach felt like he needed to get his players all on the same page, so he takes that T.O. And in a close game, T.O.'s could be big late. T-Birds still have all four of theirs. And coach holding on to them so far as best he can. On the floor for New Mexico right now, you've got Massey, Johnson, Stone, Torber, and Cherry. On the other side, you will have Green, Monten, Grant, Tate, and number 24, Caleb Gaston. Gaston had a good first half, leads all scorers in this one with 13 points. Xavier Johnson now with the basketball, Leo Torber behind him, and they'll give it off to Torber. And back to Johnson here as T-Birds are going to rotate and run a little offense. Stone, Torber. He'll work towards his right to Massey at the top of the key. Massey will back down, go up against Gaston, but it's not going to be good. It's going to be a foul. And I think against Bear Cherry, Cherry kind of cleared the way there. He's going to ask what he did wrong, but there was some contact there. His second now and the team's first. Ball back the other way, back towards Temple, and they are playing at a fast pace, as Coach said. They press about as much as the T-Birds do, and it's been a lot of fun to watch. Coach McKay said as much yesterday in the postgame interview after the T-Bird victory. Long three up, no good for Grant. Offensive board and a put back there. Though for Green, Green averages almost 9 a game. I believe that's his first bucket of the game. It is. 49-47, T-Birds still in the lead, and they have the ball. Xavier Johnson all by himself for three from the corner. And Johnson, with his first bucket of the game, puts T-Birds up by five. 52-47 with 17 minutes to go now in the ball game. Temple gets it down low back to Green, who will hit the hook shot over Jerry. 52-49 now, 4 points for Green. T-Birds up by three here, and could have been a foul there, and a loose ball picked up by Massey, and he's going to get called. Oh, I thought he was going to get called for a charge there. It's going to be a blocking call, and Coach McKay out on the floor to ask some questions. I mean, there's been some tough calls or tough no calls here in this one. So, heading to the line will be Massey. By the way, the foul was on Munton, his first, team's third here. Antoine Massey at the stripe has six in the game. Make it seven as he'll sink that one. I tell you what, both NMJC coaches and some of the fans now really chirping at the officials here during the free throw. Second one no good for Massey, and Temple comes back up the floor trailing by four. They'll get it into the corner. Gaston with 13, steps back, puts it up, way short. Chayden Stone will get the rebound for the T-Birds, and he'll be back up the floor. Torber now to Massey in the corner. Massey will look to drive, and he'll get around to everybody, put it off the glass and in. And it is now 9 points for Antoine Massey, five here in this second half. And it's 55-49, T-Birds with a six-point lead. Their largest of the game for New Mexico. They've trailed by as many as seven. Torber forcing the steal on Munton, gets it ahead. Two, Stone for the one-handed dunk. And Chayton throws it down, 10 for Stone. And the T-Birds are up by eight, largest lead of the game by either side. T-Birds off to a good start here in the second half. Under 16 minutes to play. Cherry with good defense. Goes straight up, denies the Temple player. Stone no good on his layup. Antoine Massey with an offensive rebound and a putback. Timeout Temple. T-Birds up by 10. It's 59-49. We'll be back in just a moment. Back here at Kester Activity Center, where your T-Birds have come alive on the defensive side, leading to some good transition buckets, and Antoine Massey really making some things happen on both sides of the floor here for the Thunderbirds early in this second half. 15-39 remains in half number two, with the T-Birds up by 10, 59-49, right now on a 12-3 run to open the half. Can't ask for much more than that out of your team. And now just one timeout left here. Oh, no, they're saying two still up on the board. I think it's just one timeout left. T-Birds did not take that one. Had to be Temple. You're not even inside the 5 minutes for the media there. So I believe they've only got the one left. That's showing two on the board, but we'll double-check that here later. 15-39, T-Birds up by 10. Temple and White will have the ball as we begin action again. Massey guarding against Gaston. Good drive, and he'll just toss it over. Massey hits the floor, trying to stop. It's an 8-point game, 59-51 after the bucket there. And Massey will get it back on the other side, spins, looks to go up, has his shot blocked. Offensive rebound, and another by Johnson. And driving now is Stone out into the corner. Massey, way short on the three. Cherry gets it, goes right back up and in. Count the bucket, and there's a foul. This one against number 12, Desmond Green, I believe his first. Green with 6 points in the game for Temple, all in this half, including the last bucket. T-Birds back up by 10 as Cherry, again, with that size, gets the bucket to fall and goes to the stripe. Can't get it to go, and we're going to have, I think, a foul against me. Nope, it's going to go against Xavier Johnson. His first, second team foul. Out is Johnson, in is Luca Beret. Luca out of a South Australia here for the Thunderbirds. Has 8 points off the bench, all in the first half. This is first action here in half number two, and he'll be working against Tate. Ball is thrown low. Back to Green. Green will have to give it off. And that is, oh my goodness. Tough call against Cherry here. That's going to be three on Bear now, and that's going to give Coach McKay a little bit of something to worry about. It's kind of, that was a pretty weak call. Going baseline that time, though, was Caleb Gaston, and he lost his footing, went down. Bear just there, and the whistle blew. So that's one broadcaster's opinion. So, as you can tell, I disagree with the stripes on that one. But the T-Birds up by 10, 61-51, on a pretty good roll here, I believe. 14-5 to start this second half over Temple. Temple now finds themselves trailing, but will have an inbound here. Three team fouls against T-Birds here already in 5 minutes, 14 seconds here in this half. Four the other way for Temple. So seven fouls called in 5 minutes here on either side. It's been a little tightly called at times. Then it'll loosen up for a bit. It's kind of back and forth so far. I think a pretty well-called game overall by the officiating crew. So we'll come out of this timeout here. And we have corrected. There's only one timeout left for Temple. And again, in a close game, that could come into play. T-Birds with all four of theirs. Cherry back out on the floor, even with the three fouls here. 13 points and 8 boards for Cherry so far in the game. It'd be a big loss if he has to sit for very long. The inbound comes all the way out to Green. Green will pick up his dribble. Now has nowhere to go with it. Torber giving fits to Monten. Monten will get it, go right against Torber. They'll go back underneath and unable to make the shot with the contest, or the contest there from Cherry was Green. All the way to the rack, but not getting the shot to fall this time is Leo Torber. Back up the floor comes Gaston with the basketball for the Leopards. Working against Ayul. Now over to Monten. Monten will get it down. It's going to be Tate, it looks like, down low. Is that Gaston down low? It was. Not so. At times, it's hard to see the gold numbers on the white jerseys. That's the pause and the call there for my side anyways, folks. Torbert bangs a dunk off the rim, and it'll go out of bounds back over to Temple. He's wide open by himself, tries to throw it down really hard. Must have lost it. It goes off the rim and out. T-Birds had a chance to go back up by 10 there. Now lead by 8. Torber immediately to the bench here. It's Bray, Ayul, Bailey, Benjamin, and Cherry in. A smaller lineup for the Thunderbirds here. And that should be T-Bird basketball. It is. Bad inbound pass from Gaston. Just one of those moments where you don't know what he was thinking. T-Birds will get it back here, fortunately, and Benjamin will hand off to Bailey. Bailey being guarded by Monten. They'll go back across. Beret setting the screen here. gets the pick. Benjamin's on the far side. Borrego get it back. And at the top of the key, he'll go towards the bucket. Leaves it short on the layup, though. And here comes Gaston with the basketball for Temple. Almost loses it there. Ayul with a reach. Gaston gets to the bucket, puts it in. So Caleb Gaston gets that one to fall. Ayul gets the foul. That is two on Ayul. And each team now with four team fouls here. 61-55, the 10-point lead back to just six for the T-Birds, maybe five if the free throw falls here for Caleb Gaston. Jim awfully quiet here. His free throw about to go up. 13-32 remaining in the ballgame. Gaston's free throw is no good. It rattles out. He's 0 for 2 from the stripe is what I have him for. And T-Birds get the rebound. Back up the floor comes Elijah Bailey for New Mexico. And he'll just go right at the rack. Has it blocked by Gaston this time. And back up the floor is Cameron Roper. Temple. Roper loses it. It rolls to Gaston, luckily, for the Leopards. Trying to get a shot off. Could not do it. That's a tie ball as Luca Barre with a good defensive play. Ties up Desmond Green. The ball will remain here with Temple College. Bear Cherry getting a breather here with 13:05 to go in the second half now. T-Birds still up by six, but it is Temple with the basketball. They'll inbound. To do the honors is Roper. He'll get it over and into, it looked like Tate. That's a travel there. No call. He had the ball, lost it off his chest, and Green got away with one. Four on the shot clock. Trying to go at Benjamin is Roper. He's in trouble here. One, and they won't get a shot off. Second shot clock violation for the Thunderbird defense here today. T-Birds will get it on the far side. Bereda inbound. T-Birds still up by six. Benjamin will take the inbound from Luca, and he will go against. Looks like he'll step back now anyways. And the defense was being played here. Can't even tell the number there. The gold on the white makes it tough. Either way, 61-55. Benjamin misses the three. There's a push. And Grant trying to finally get himself going here. Still just with the 4 points in the game. T-Birds come away with it. Massey will go up for the dunk. He's fouled. That should be possibly an intentional foul. He never made a play on the ball. He didn't make a play on the basketball. The gentleman didn't. That'll be Grant's first foul. And guarding, by the way, a moment ago was Tate. So Massey will go to the line for a couple of free throws here. And way short on that one is Antoine. It'll get a second look, though, as some substitutions come in. It is going to be Chaden Stone back in the game for your Thunderbirds. So Bailey, Benjamin, Stone, Ayul, and Massey in the game for New Mexico. And the other way, looks like it's Sincere Shaw back in the game, who's had a good one. He had 11 in the first half alone, 3 knocked down shots from long distance, and the rebound grabbed this time by Jarrell Peoples back in the game. 61-55, T-Birds led by 10, now by 6 here with about 12 minutes to go. That one thrown away, out of bounds again, and a horrible pass. And the guard taking responsibility for that one, I do believe, is going to be number 20, Jason Holder. Torber back in the game for the T-Birds, has 2 fouls, including the technical he picked up earlier. Now some discussion on the sideline as referee wipes the basketball off. Don't know what's on it. They may want up. Oh, ball's still fine, I guess. After the it gets tailed off by the official here, you don't see that very often in play. So on the side, the T-Birds will have the basketball. To inbound it will be Chaden Stone. Benjamin, Bailey, and Torber, all guards in the game that can handle the rock. Massey's going to handle the duties down low for the time being. Benjamin blows around everybody, almost loses the ball, gets it back, and misses the shot. Gets it back again. Is blocked this time by Iyama back in the game. And a pull up from about the free throw line off the glass. Didn't hear him call it, but it'll fall for Shaw. 13 now for Shaw. It's back to just a 4-point T-Bird lead. Bailey got down to four. Now we'll back it back out for New Mexico. 11 and a half to go in this one. Deuce thought about it. Never left his feet. Now he does. And there was lots of contact two or three times. But Massey will come away with the basketball off the miss. And Coach McKay not liking what he's seeing. He'll call the TO here with the T-Birds up by six. 63-57 after Antoine's bucket there. Twan now with 13 in the game. And the T-Birds lead it again, 63-57. 11:19 to go in this second half. And we'll be back in a moment. Okay, back out of the timeout at Castor Activity Center here on the campus of New Mexico Junior College, right here in Hobbs, New Mexico. I'm Dusty Windham. Today's action between Temple and your T-Birds has been fast. It's been furious. I think we have an issue maybe with blood on the jersey or something here, or a nosebleed is what it looks like for Peoples for Temple. And he has to go to the sideline. Looking for some help from the JC training staff here. And he'll get it, that's for sure. Long pass from Green into the corner. Step back and a shot here from number 20, and that is Holder. T-Birds get a rebound and they'll call a foul on it? Is that what it was? Or did they say he's out? What is the call? I don't see anything going up on the board. Coach McKay didn't like it. A couple of the fans here in the stands didn't like it, but the ball will go back over to Temple. 11:03 remaining now in this second half, and a long inbound pass will go to Iyama. And outside to Sincere Shaw, and he'll hit it again. Five in the second half, and a steal perhaps for him as he saves it coming in out of bounds. T-Birds will get it back, and Bailey will go underneath to Massey. He's blocked from behind by Shaw. Doing a little bit of everything here. And a technical foul called now against number 24, Gaston, I believe. Or no, is it going to be? Yeah, it's going to be Shaw. DT, that's just going to be his first foul. So T-Birds will get a free throw. I think the ball will go back over. So Stone will head to the stripe for the T-Birds to see if he can stretch the lead back to four. He cannot. T-Birds shooting poorly from the free throw line in this one. Cherry checks back in for Massey here. And Stone does hit the second free throw. 3-for-4 from the stripe for Chayden in this one. And the ball will go back over to Temple here after the Class B, which I learned just a moment ago. 64-60, though. This game getting a little tighter. T-Birds were up by 10 a few moments ago. There's the inbound. Shaw will get it back from Green. It will be Holder with it. No, excuse me, that is not Holder. That is Sanchez Perez. I've been giving Holder credit for some of Sanchez Perez's stuff here. With the basketball is Roper. He's going to look for some space. Goes underneath to Green. Good pass and a good shot. Oh, it is Ayama out there. Excuse me. Forgot it. He had the four fouls and came back in. Just a two-point game now as the T-Birds will get it back. There's a foul on Roper. His second team's, is that seven? So it'll be a one-on-one opportunity here for Luca Beret as Roper gambled on the steal and just got a piece of Luca instead. Out again is, it looked like it was Desmond Green taking a seat on the far side. Yes, it was. And now waiting for the free throws here. Everybody in the gym, including myself. 10, 12 to go. And Bray sinks his first. He'll get a second look at it. 9 points for Luca in this one. T-Birds back up by three. Again, 10 minutes, 12 seconds to go in this second half. And it's been a back-and-forth affair. Each team is led by 7, 8, 9, and 10. And both shots will fall for Luca here, putting the T-Birds back up by four, 66-62. But a very good game all the way around. It's a one-point game at the half. Another good pass on the interior underneath to Iyama, and Iyama will score again. Iyama now with four, both of his buckets coming within the last minute of play. Cherry gets it underneath, goes up. He'll get it back. It looks like it was tipped the first time. Oh, back iron, no good this time. And back up the floor will come Perez, I believe. Now ball back out to Yama, then to Perez, and a tough call there is the ball will go back. I think it's going to stick with actually the white shirts here. We're into our media timeout. Crew a little late and signaling anything other than this media timeout here. And we'll see what happens when we come back. We've got a good one here at Caster. 9:33 remains. It is 66-64. T-Birds over Temple. And Temple on a roll in the last about 3 minutes offensively. We'll see what the T-Birds can do after the timeout here. Coming back out of a media timeout here in just a moment with some more basketball action. The T-Birds with a two-point lead, 9:33 remains in this second half. And, man, it's been back and forth. Each team throwing haymakers in this one. It's been a battle the entire way. T-Birds led it 46-45 at the half. Now just have a two-point lead. They've led by as many as 10, though. They came out on a 15-4 run to open up the second half, and since that time, it has been Temple battling back, hitting some shots, and good defense inside for this Leopard team to push them back to within a bucket of tying this one up. All the way back into the backcourt for Iyama. He'll give it off now to Roper. Roper will get it back across midcourt. 10 on the shot clock. T-Birds have already forced two shot clock violations. Xavier Johnson working on Roper here. They'll get it to Gaston. Gaston will lose it. He'll try to get it to Yama, who recognizes and puts up a long three that just barely misses. Off front iron, then the glass. T-Birds will come away with the rebound. Torber with the basketball now for New Mexico, looking to extend the lead. He tries to drive, loses it. Luckily, Johnson's there because it just went straight to a T-Bird. Torber's going to pick up another foul. Goes over the back again of Perez. Three on Leo, not having his best game here today, as he's only got 4 points on the board and a technical to boot for the T-Birds. But Leo, one of those guys that'll get it going. That's an offensive foul against Roper as he elbows Xavier Johnson in the face. Xavier will take that one, and Roper picks up his third, eighth team foul. It's not going to be free throws here for Johnson, is it? It's an offensive foul is what the call was. So the T-Birds will have to inbound here. Should be a new shot clock. They've got 20 up there. We'll see if they do change it when the ball inbounds. They did not. Weird. And now underneath, Cherry's going to get called for a foul as Iyama hits the floor. Four on Bear now, and you'll probably see him take a long break here momentarily. Coach will leave him in with four. Sixth team foul. And now Roper will take the inbound, give it back off to Gaston. Gaston will work against Ayul, back to Roper, working against Leo Torber. Iyama all the way out. And Lax pass, Torber with the steal. He'll lay it up and in softly this time after missing the dunk earlier. Six now for Leo. T-Birds back up by four at 68-64, under 8.5 to play now in the ballgame. Roper will go towards his right out into the corner. Wide open is Sincere Shaw. That's his fifth made tray, I believe, of the game. It is. He's got 19 points, and the T-Birds keep leaving him open. Got to get a hand on him. One-point game, 68-67. Ayul for three as Gaston leaves him open. He'll miss, though. Yama comes away with the rebound and another bad pass. Ayul will come away with the basketball on the steal. So T-Birds get another turnover. And it's Jayden Stone with the bucket there. Big bucket for the Thunderbirds. Back down the floor is going to be Gaston. Ayul will get called for the foul, but he didn't give up the bucket. Two free throws coming here for Caleb Gaston. Three on Ayul and 17 foul. Deuce Benjamin up off the bench will enter the game after the next stoppage here as Gaston will get his first shot. Two free throws coming here for him. He's 0 for 2 from the stripe. Now 1 for 3. He'll sink that one, and it's a two-point game, 70-68. Deuce back in, taking a seat this time is Ayul with his three fouls. And could be back to a one-point game here. It is, as Gaston's able to hit both of them. Gaston with 19 ties his teammate Shaw for the game high in points here, 19 apiece. Stone travels, and Gaston forces that one. Stone trying to, he looks up like he's going to shoot and then thought about driving, just didn't put the ball on the floor quick enough. Moves his feet, and the T-Birds turn it over yet again. It's a one-point game and a chance for Temple to take their first lead of the second half here. Trying to get around Torber was Perez. They'll get it to Yama, back over to Roper. Roper now will work. Has to go against Cherry. I think they're going to call Xavier Stone here. And coach is saying, look, you kicked out on that one. Either way, it is a foul against Johnson. I don't like to call either. When the shooter kicks out at a player, shouldn't be a foul on the defense. That's all I'm saying. And it's a jump shot. You know, it's not a layup. It's not like he's going at him. Just a jump shot, but Roper will get to the stripe. Fittingly misses his first. 1 of 3 from the stripe now for his single point in the game for Cameron Roper. See if he can sink number two and tie this one up, and he does. So, 70 apiece, 7:15 remaining in the game. T-Birds with the basketball, and it's Leo Torber back over to Jayden Stone. Stone for the long three. No, off back iron, no good. Gaston gets the rebound. Or no, it was Perez with the rebound. Now back up the floor comes Roper. Oh, my goodness. He just leans back into a T-Bird player and gets a foul call. It's Johnson again, though. No, that's three. Johnson's got to give up the lane every now and then. He's leaning into him most of the way up the floor anyways. Could have had the call. And that is 9 team fouls now for the Thunderbirds. And back to the line is Roper. Roper 2 for 4 from the stripe. Is that correct? Yeah. 2 for 5 now as he'll miss that one. And he'll get another look. T-Bird substitutions will have Johnson. You also have Benjamin, Massey, Torber, and I do believe Bailey. Yes, it's Elijah Bailey in the game. Roper's second. No good as well. Just 2 for 6 from the stripe in the game is Roper. And the T-Birds are fortunate for that. Tied at 70, under 7 to go in the ball game. T-Birds and Temple. Bailey for New Mexico gets it underneath to Massey, up and off the glass, and it's in. Twan now with a team high 15. And here come the Leopards, trailing by 2, 72-70, 6.5 to go. They'll go for Iyama. he'll give it off here before Perez pushes off. And now Iyama gets it back. He elbows. They elbow Massey. Massey is hurt, limping up the floor. There's a two-handed dunk on the other side. But that's a complete missed call off the elbow. I'm not going to say what I really want to say about it, but 6-10 to go now in the game, 72 apiece. That bucket came, I believe, may have been for Iyama. It was. He's got six now, all in this second half. And Massey will get looked at on the sideline. Bear back in the game, but he's got four fouls. Benjamin will back it out. Back to Leo Torber. Torber working against Roper. Now gets the screen from Bear. Little floater in the lane. Short. Bear will get the rebound. He'll go back up. He is hacked. Take your pick on this one. I believe it's going to be on Iyama, and that'll do it for him. He is fouled out of this one with six, averaging 10 a game. And that is 19 fouls. Now Bear will go to the line after the timeout here. 5:49 to go in this second half. Shouldn't be a timeout at all. Okay, now back out to the floor. Yeah, they were calling the media timeout there. It's not even at the 5-minute mark here. And both teams will now head back out on the floor. Cherry at the stripe after the foul. Iyama, again, Andrew Iyama fouls out of the game. And Cherry's free throw, no good. Gets another look here. And hopefully can put the T-Birds up by a point here at Castor at home, where they have not lost on the season. Second free throw is good for Bear. Cherry now with 14 points on the afternoon. 73-72, T-Birds lead, 5:40 remaining in the second half. Bailey with the defense against Roper, all the way to the far side. Shaw with five trays in the game, and now wide open is going to be Peoples for three, and he'll drain it. Five for Jarrell Peoples in this one, and the T-Birds find themselves down two. 75-73, Torber all the way out to, or all the way down the floor, gets it out to Xavier Johnson, and that one hangs, but finally falls from three-point range for Johnson. His second tray of the game, he's got six, and T-Birds back up by one. 76-75, Roper on the drive. Gets towards the bucket and misses, but a rebound by Peoples. And another one, this time by Roper. What a steal by Torber. It'll go, no! It looked like it went off the hands of the white shirt there, as it looked like Grant got a piece of it. It'll go out of bounds and will now be a media timeout. So the music can start. We can too. We're going to take a break here. T-Birds up by one. 76-75 over a very good Temple team here at Castor Activity Center. If you're not here, you're missing a good one, folks. I tell you that, the crowd, good again for a Sunday afternoon tip, and most students off campus. Community turning out once again for the T-Birds. We're gonna take our break here. 4:58 to go in this one. T-Birds up by one. Back once again here at Castor Activity Center. 4:58 to go here in half number two. T-Birds clinging to a one-point lead. Relinquished that lead just a moment ago on a big three-pointer from Jarrell Peoples and Temple. And T-Birds come back down to four. Xavier Johnson able to regain the lead for your Thunderbirds. As he sinks a tray. 76-75 your score. Half was 46-45, each team with 30 here in half number two. Gaston going at the bucket. Bear Cherry with a big block. They'll get it ahead now. As Johnson finds Stone, and there's another bad foul. Just, I tell you what, you're going to have to call something. It's getting a little too physical on breakaways. I don't think he made a play on the ball either. He just grabbed his arm and pulled him down. 10 team fouls now. That one goes against number one Roper. A little chippy, a little dirty. An elbow to Massey that wasn't called. And Massey had to go to the sidelines after getting elbowed in the midsection. And now Stone will miss the free throw. Stone hit the floor hard. Good to see that he's back up, though. I tell you, there's a lot of physical play here, and a lot of times you can't see everything, can't call everything. No official can. It's impossible. Stone will hit the second to give the T-Birds a two-point lead at 77-75. Three put up by Guest. No way! That is a horrible call. Horrible call on the three-point shot. Bear Cherry doesn't even go at him. The gentleman falls into Bear, and the call is made. If I'm coach, I'm getting thrown out of this one. I'm telling you now, that's a horrible call. That is the worst call I've seen today, and there's been some bad ones. Jacob Gaston now will go to the free throw line for three gimmies, and they'll foul out the T-Bird big on a BS call. Gaston off front iron misses. I agree, it was a flop, not called. And Cherry has to take a seat for the rest of this game on that call. That's could change the complexity of the game, and that's why it is such a bad call. First two free throws out of three missed here by Gaston. Not having his best line at the game, but he has scored at will today. 19 points for Caleb Gaston. He finally hits that one. One of three from the stripe to bring it back to just a one-point game. And a bad inbound pass that time by Johnson. T-Birds need to get their heads in this game. 4.5 to go. T-Birds do get it as it's tipped, and Stone came away with it. Massey sets the screen against Roper. The floater in the lane, no good. Massey had the putback, can't get it to fall. Roper with the basketball now for Tipple, looking to regain the lead. And he'll nicely dish that one off to Peoples. Peoples will get the bucket and back up our Temple. 78-77, what a pass by Roper. Really good look that time. Inside, Gaston holding Massey, nobody looking at it. In fact, one official's looking at the wall, not even watching the game on the near side. That's terrible. T-Birds will miss it, the ball will go back up the floor. The guy on the near side was staring at the wall, not even watching anybody play. There was nobody in between him and the wall. He's looking at the wall. That's not an official's job. I'm sorry. There's a foul by Stone as he'll bump Grant. And Grant will go to the line for two. They're wanting them to count that bucket. This is not the NBA, folks. He took two steps afterwards. He's going to get his free throws. The foul, by the way, on Stone, his first. And a miss at the stripe. The T-Birds are lucky that the Leopards have shot so poorly from the stripe in this one. Second one does fall this time. And it is now 5 points for Grant on the day. He averages 19 a game. T-Birds have done great on him. Not so much on Shaw or on Gaston in this one. Gaston with 20, 19 for Shaw. Five threes made as well. At the bucket goes Torbert. Contact. He gets the bucket to fall. No whistle. T-Birds want the whistle. Can't get it. Massey with a good defensive play to stop Grant from getting an easy bucket on that one. 3:14 to go in this one. We're tied at 79. Been a great game here. Back and forth the whole way. And both teams fighting hard here. The inbound. And they turn around there. Torber's going to get called for the foul. He's arguing that he got elbowed in the head, and he did. Yet they'll call Torber for the foul. And going to the line again is going to be the Temple College side. I think they've got 97 free throws. That's an exaggeration, folks. But going to the line is going to be Peoples here. He's got 7, I believe, in the game. And he'll get a couple looks here. 4 fouls on Torber. 3 on Xavier Johnson. The first free throw does fall for Peoples. And they've got a 1-point lead. Does Temple at 80-79. Let's see. 2 apiece on Massey and also on Benjamin in the game. And 1 foul for Stone. Both free throws will fall for Peoples. It's a 2-point game. T-Birds trail it 81-79. Inbound now to Torber. Leo will have to play tough with these 4 fouls. And it's hard to play good defense with 4 fouls. Leo into the lane, lays it up. No! Antoine Massey on the putback dunk with 2 hands. Tied at 81. Antoine Massey saving the T-Birds today. He's had a really good game out here. Good to see for Twan. Roper trying to get in there. That's going to be an offensive foul. Best call of the game. But this time he wasn't staring at the wall and makes the call. T-Birds will get it back. That is 5 on Cameron Roper. He'll check out this game with a whole 2 points. The average is 6.6. T-Birds have done a good job on him. Montin back in for the first time in a long time. As he'll be in Aino Montin from Finland. I'd lie if I told you I could pronounce the name of the town in Finland he's from. T-Birds will get it back here. 2:40 to go. It's tied at 81. Stone with it. He'll back it out, working against Peoples. Now back to Torber. 2.5 to go. This one has been back and forth and hotly contested. Torber again gets contact, still finishes, no call underneath the bucket. 83-81 as Leo now has 10. Deuce Benjamin here working against Shaw. Out to Montin. Montin has to work against Leo Torber. He's got to play good D here. Does not foul the kick out. Comes all the way to Grant. Grant tries to drive. Now kicks out. It is going to be Gaston for 3, and he'll hit it. Going back up by 1 is the Temple College Leopards. 2 minutes to go in this one. It's 84-83, and too many open looks from the perimeter for the T-Bird D here. But it's a 1-point game with 2 to go. We'll see what happens the rest of the way when we come back. Back here in the, final 2 minutes of this game. And a big shot by Caleb Gaston there. As he'll hit the tray from the corner, but the T-Birds have given up probably 15 wide open looks from 3-point range in this game. That's due to ball movement and the scheme, I'm sure, of the offense and the defense just missing an assignment here and there. But Temple's done a really good job of springing their guys open for shots from the perimeter in this game. And now they lead it by 1. 46-45 was your score at the half. Now 84-83. T-Birds had the lead at the half. Now the other way goes the lead. T-Birds have led by as many as 10 in this second half and just cannot keep the consistency on the offensive end of the floor. All of the officials now huddling as the T-Birds will come out of the timeout here. T-Birds will have the basketball. Trailing by 1, 2 minutes to go. And it will be Leo Torber in the game, as well as Xavier Johnson, who inbounds it there to Stone. Back to Deuce Benjamin. As Luke Faye said before the game, Benjamin in at the end, as you want your best kids out there. Coach puts him all on the floor. And Benjamin will get it back here. 12 on the shot clock. Stone back to Benjamin. Over to Johnson. Back to Deuce. Deuce fakes the 3, puts it on the floor, back out. Stone, 4 on the shot clock. They'll get it inside to Torber. He'll score it again. Leo taking over offensively late for the T-Birds here in this one. T-Birds back up by 1 point, 1:24 to go. Gaston with a big offensive foul. Easy call on that one. And his coach is hot. So three on Gaston. Caleb Gaston leads his team in scoring 23 points in the game. Hit the big three a minute ago. Take the lead. T-Birds will get the ball down the floor and now pull it back out. Minute 17 to go here. T-Birds up 85-84. What a ball game this one's been. Shaw, Benjamin now with the basketball. Will kick it over to Massey. Massey puts it on the floor once. Bounces, puts it up and in. Antoine Massey with 19 now in the game. Giving the T-Birds a three-point lead. Less than a minute to go now. Gaston with it again. He's going to look for some space. He tried to hook. And he tried to hook Massey. Didn't get around him. Travels with the basketball. T-Birds get it back. Timely defense for the T-Birds. Up by three. 51 seconds left in this one. T-Birds with the basketball. And they throw it away. Yet again, Johnson has three or four turnovers late in this one. And what a defensive play to get it back from Stone. Stone and Benjamin get the ball back for the T-Birds. And now, with 37 seconds to go, they're going to use some clock before they head towards the bucket. There's 17-16 on the shot clock now. Stone will pull up from three because he's wide open. He misses off front iron. And coming away with it was Peoples. Now back to Gaston. Gaston's going to look to drive. Trying to go against Massey. They'll kick it out to Grant. Grant, not much going for him today. That ball will hit the guy wire off the miss, and the T-Birds will get it back. Coach will take the timeout. Coach McKay takes the timeout for the Thunderbirds. They're up by three, 12 seconds to go. It'll be a situation where Tipple has to foul. Timely performances in this one late in this game, overcoming some adversity late in the second half. The T-Birds have trailed in the last 2 minutes of this ball game. Now back up by three. It was it 84-83 was our score a moment ago. T-Birds now up and have a chance to ice this one at the stripe perhaps as they'll inbound and look to get it. We'll see who they look to get it to. Stone today, 4 of 6 from the stripe. And we'll see who they come back out on the floor with as well. Bear Cherry has fouled out of this one. Antoine has had to step up big in that post position for the T-Birds late in this one as Coach McKay has had to really fight for this one. Bear, of course, fouled out on a call that was questionable at best in this one. It was a flop, in my opinion, out on the sideline. And we'll see here coming out of this timeout who the T-Birds go with. It will be Johnson, Torber, Luca Beret, Chayden Stone, and Deuce Benjamin. You would assume Luca's in there to get some free throws, maybe just for the size that he possesses out there as well, the 6'6 sophomore. They'll go all the way down the floor. Wide open is Torber. Nobody was there. One-handed dunk. Four-point lead for the T-Birds, and almost a steal from Stone on the inbound. And the T-Birds are up by 5 with 10 seconds to go. How does that happen? You cannot let anybody get that wide open when you trail it. And back up the floor comes Shaw. He'll pull up for a three with 5 seconds to go. It rattles out. T-Birds will get the rebound, and they'll hang on in this one. 89-84 NMJC. The Thunderbirds still perfect at home on the season with all kinds of adversity faced. I tell you what, that might be their best win on the season so far. And just the adversity they faced, the poise they showed towards the end of the game, more so than even myself at times in this broadcast. And they're able to hang on and win this one. What a game. Temple comes in solid. They lose to South Plains yesterday. They lose to your T-Birds today. They'll leave here 7-5 on the season. And your T-Birds will go 11-1, 10 games above 500 here with just, I think, one more before the break. We'll talk with head coach Luke McKay momentarily. But what a game that was. T-Birds come away with the victory, 89-84 here at Castor Activity Center. We'll be back in a few. Oh, what a game the T-Birds had. Faced adversity. They faced a deficit. They come back late. And a total problem for Temple, leaving Leo Torber wide open on that. I don't know how you get wide open like that at the end of a game when you're trailing and you let somebody get that open. It's tough to come back from. Joining me now, head coach Luke McKay. And Luke, what a win.
Yeah, a little stressful. If I had hair, it'd be great, but we'll take it.
That makes two of us.
We'll take it. It was a good effort by the guys to play back-to-back days like that. And then finish off, Temple was a very, very good team, and they go very deep, and they press the entire time. So it takes a lot of toughness to be able to beat those guys, because they do play very, very hard, and they're very well coached.
I'm sure one of your focuses coming in was keeping number four off the scorebook, if you will, averaging 19 a game for Temple, and that's Grant. You did a really good job against him. Shaw got some shots. Gaston got some shots to go, and they shot well from the perimeter and had wide open looks at times. They must run a good scheme to get pop their guys open like that.
Yeah, they've got a lot of guys who are very, very skilled and can really, really shoot it. Obviously, you mentioned number four, Dio Grant. He's one of the best offensive players in the country. We do a great job on him. But what makes them so tough is they got so many weapons out there on the perimeter. It's hard to help because they do have guys like Shaw, number 11, and 24, Gaston, guys who can make you pay when you do help. So they're a problem in terms of matchups. I thought our guys adjusted there in the second half and came out and played a whole lot better, a little more pop, a little more energy to it, and finally got that win.
So what I saw was, at the moment, Bear Terry fouls out, Coach, in that game. It's still 6-8 minutes to go in the game, and that's a problem. Yet not a lot of huge post presence for us. Antoine Massey steps up and really, I thought, had a great game in that position late.
Yeah, Twani was fantastic. 19.6 rebounds in just 20 minutes of action is very impressive. 9-14 from the line. Obviously, losing Bear, a double-double guy who has 14 points, 10 rebounds, and 4 blocks.
Yeah.
You know, that's tough to overcome, but Twani is just he's just one of the toughest kids you're ever going to be around, and he's going to compete until he can't move anymore, and we just love him for that.
You know, the personalities of these kids, they're just so likable. You know, in the first place, you got good kids on your roster. They're talented kids, no doubt. Late in the game, you go with a smaller lineup. You got Benjamin and Bailey out there with Torber, Johnson as well. Xavier was out there. And, man, it seemed like you went for more speed than size there. Was that the thought going?
Yeah, it was. They went when 22 fouled out for them, their big guy. Now they basically went with five guards. Even though, you know, they're tall, they, like you mentioned, 11 can step out there and really shoot it. 24 can handle and shoot it. So we counted that by going small. And fortunately for us, we got guys like AZ Johnson gets 5 rebounds. Chaden Stone gets 5 rebounds. Leo gets 4 rebounds. Luca comes in and gets 5 rebounds. So while they may not be double-figure rebounders themselves like Bear, they do it as a group and they do it together to make up for that.
I thought it was a tremendous job late in the game there for you guys. I mean, you had a 10-point lead. They come back. They take a lead. And you're really facing adversity with about 2 minutes to go in the game. You're down one. And just keep coming through. Leo comes through big. In the last 2 minutes, he may have been as big as anybody in this one.
Yeah, that's what makes him so dynamic as a point guard. He's one of those guys that you don't really need to run a ton for him. You just put him in space and let him go. And at the end of the games, that's very valuable to have. You got a guy who you don't have to run too much for. He can go create. And guys like that make coaches look smart.
Well, Coach, I think you're pretty bright. I'll just say that, man. Now what's next for you?
So we've got Ranger coming up on Thursday before we go into the Christmas break, and that's going to be tough. Ranger is always a very difficult team to play, and we've got to go to their place out there before we go to Christmas. So hopefully we can go out there, get a win on the road, and have a Merry Christmas.
Well, I'm hoping so, too. Perfect at home so far on the season, although it was in jeopardy for a moment. You are perfect at home on the season, and I just want to say congrats. I've enjoyed watching this team play more so than I have a lot of teams in a lot of years. I've been doing this 29 years. And these guys are so much fun to watch, Coach. I'm digging what you guys are doing. wishes for continued success.
Thank you. I appreciate you. And they are, they're fun to watch, and they're just the most incredible kids you'll ever be around. I think when grades go in, we're going to be close to a 3.5 GPA. They are in the community. They're helping out and giving back to Hobbs as a whole, and they're just wonderful kids to be around.
You guys were at the Stuff a Bus event, were you
Yes,
not?
We were. Yes, yeah. We were out there moving those cans around, and they did a great job with a big smile on their face and helped somebody, some family, some kids somewhere have a Merry Christmas.
I tell you what, do I know how to pick them? Two places I work for, Norwalmark Broadcasting and New Mexico Junior College, doing the Stuff a Bus, doing everything for the community. Coach, that's what I love about this place. You're teaching these guys community service, how to be good men, beyond the X's and O's, and salute to you.
Thank you. I appreciate you.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Have a good Christmas.
Hey, Coach Luke McKay, I sure will, man. I hope you guys do too. T-Birds come away with the victory, 89-84, in their toughest matchup of the season so far as the adversity they faced and the pace of the game, perhaps even getting to them a little bit. 19 points from Antoine Massey, 6 boards. And they still leading the way here. 14 apiece for Stone, Torber, and Cherry. Cherry also with 10 boards and 4 blocks. The double-double there for him. Let's see, for Stone, he also had 3 steals, 2 assists, 5 rebounds. For Torber, to go along with his 14, he had 6 assists, 4 boards, and a couple of steals in this game. Off the bench, Luca Bray with 10. A very good performance for Luca. In this one, he had 5 rebounds to go along with it and an assist. 6 points more for Elijah Bailey, a couple of assists, a couple of steals. He had a rebound. And 5 from Deuce Benjamin. Might not have lit up the scoreboard the way you're used to seeing Deuce do in this one. But I tell you what, he is a big part of what happened out here today. He gave the guards fits when they were bringing the ball up and down the floor. He only had 16 minutes tonight, but still a couple of boards in there to go along with his 5 points on the evening. 1 point from Ayul came early on in the game, but he had 3 rebounds, an assist, and a steal, and probably more altered shots than you could believe in this one. Massey took that elbow late, came back in, and really made things happen for the Thunderbirds. That offsets the 23 points from Gaston, the 19 from Shaw. They did a heck of a job on Grant in this one because that kid can flat out score. Just watching him yesterday, I like the way he plays as well. But the T-Birds will finally come away with the victory after a hard-fought game here today. Couldn't be more proud of this team and the way they played at the end of that ball game. That's going to do it for us. Let me see when we're going to be back again on air here at New Mexico Junior College as I look at my upcoming schedule in my calendar here on the phone. And you never know. It's going to be a lot of fun. That will be, well, our next stop will be against McCook Community College. It'll be women's basketball here. And that will come up next Friday, the 15th, here at Castor Activity Center. Be sure to make it out as most of the students are off campus as the holiday break has hit here in the academic year. And you know what? Good crowds this weekend. Can't thank the community enough for that, for coming out on the weekend here. But the number 4 ranked Thunderbird women back in action Friday the 15th against McCook right here at Castor Activity Center. I'll be here to bring you the action. And until then, I'll be calling some high school ball elsewhere. But what a win here today for the Thunderbirds. Just a tremendous effort by both sides and Temple. I got a feeling we'll be seeing them perhaps again later in the year in Region 5 as they can flat out score the basketball. We will again be back next Friday. I'm Dusty Windham for New Mexico Junior College. Have a great rest of your weekend.
work.